Welcome back to the RimWorld. Yes, the RimWorld now. If I remember rightly, last time we were building a cemetery. Well, not so much as a cemetery, but more of a crematorium. It's a room full of death. Because there's no point dragging all the bodies inside of our base, because it just takes so goddamn long to get out. I mean, look at everybody. They're all like, they're going for some benefits. It's the benefit line. Driving out. Oh god, all the corpses. God, how many corpses do we have? This is too many. So yeah, I've got it on a separate system. The solar generators will be generating power over time. I mean, these batteries, I don't think they'll ever get empty, but if they do, whoop-de-doo. I mean, what can you do? For some reason, this still hasn't been finished. I think McClaw's doing it now. At least he's on his way to doing it. A trade ship is passing by. Well, holy crap, look at our money. What's with all the money? Why do we got so much money? I just realized we've got so much money. Ram, do us a favor, grab the combat supply. Is that the... I can't tell. Combat supply. There we go. We've got absolutely nothing for you. But maybe, just maybe you've got something for me. Yeah, we'll grab an R4 rifle. Never have too many of those. We'll have another power armor helmet because, well, you can never have too many of those either. No point getting melee weapons because we don't do melee! Well, at least until there's personal energy shields, which should be in the game soonish. So, yeah, awesome. White, what's your shooting skill? Terrible. You don't deserve it. You don't deserve it. So you've got a dead squirrel, a bunch of dead corpses. How many corpses do we have? 24 so far. 24. That's disgusting. Now 25. And yet there's still more to bring in. But at least everybody has to do is just drag that from there to there. It's good. It'll do the job. The only problem is getting these resources to and from the base, but I'm not too worried about it. I might turn that into wood as well. Not that it matters too much. I thought that was enemies then. Don't shit me up, game. Synth thread. Oh, well, we'll take it. That's one thing I've been meaning to have a little look into. Making clothes. Not that we really need any because we're starting to fill people with armor and Carrie's doing a good job in cleaning everything up. I figured I may as well explore some of the things. I mean, you got sculpture making, but I know that takes forever, if I remember rightly. And also, it's a bit of a waste of time because we don't really do melee. So it doesn't make any sense to have a smithing table. But I think we've got one anyway. A sculptor's table, yeah. We can make a sculpture, whatever the point of that is. Make weapons. We can make a couple of ranged weapons so we can live like tribals if we really wanted to. And we've also got the tailor's workbench where we can make a whole bunch of different clothes. I imagine you can make that. Yes, you can make kind of like hyperweave and stuff, but only if you like grow it. I think you can grow Devil Strand. I think. Let us check the growing zone and find out. Yeah, we can grow some Devil Strand. So we can actually make Devil Strand clothing, but apparently it takes an eternity to grow. We have absolutely no shortage of medical supplies, do we? Heck, even our normal medical supplies are catching up with the herbal medicine, which is really crappy. So we're not going to grow any more herbal medicine on that. We'll have one patch, but I think the other lot will be Devil Strand. Yeah, we'll grow ourselves some Devil Strand. I think these roses increase the desirability of the area to make it look pretty, but nah, don't care about that. And, oh crap! McClaw is crafting something out of human meat. However the hell we got that. I don't know how we got it, but we got it. Oh, that was what I was figuring out, wasn't it? Human meat. Because at the butcher table, I don't think you can chop... Oh god, never mind. Trobo's chopping up a human body on the slab. Oh, wow, we got human leather and human meat.
Well,
Trobo, you've debunked that myth for me. That's extremely scary. Yeah, we just chop up and have the human meat ready for me. Can we actually put them in meals? Yes, of course we can put them in the meals. I don't even want to know what could happen if we put human meat in there. I'm assuming it might be fine, maybe. I don't really want to know. So yeah, so he's just finished growing something. I don't know what he's grown. He's grown an eyeball. So who was it with the cataracts, man? It was McKinney. Right, McKinney, we have just grown an eye. Can we install it? Nope. Oh, hold on. Wait, what? Where'd that come from? You know, I've never noticed this part. I've been looking on this part this entire time, and then suddenly we've got this part over here. Oh. Install a natural eye. There we go. Can't believe I didn't notice this. I was looking down this and then crossing it off. Oh. Well, let's... Wait. What's the difference between install natural eye and install eye? I think one's a mod and one's not. Well, either way, we'll install natural eye. Yeah. I think it's just a mod. Just because it's a mod. Spartak managed to throw that over the wall. So yeah, the date is June 10th. So it's 12 degrees Celsius outside. We do not need any heaters on, do we? Oh, we don't. Seems I've done that in another episode. What are you doing with that meat? Why are you putting... Oh, yeah, well, whatever. I'll allow this. Put the meat in the freezer. I'm thinking about actually making this freezer bigger. Not too much bigger, but a little bit bigger. Storing more food is always a high priority. We're never short on it, but it never hurts to have extras. Another thing I've been wanting to look into doing now is building a ship. I think it's time we started looking into it. I mean, we've got over 20 colonists now. It's time to consider building a spaceship. Now, where to build it? No idea. I don't really want to build it in the northern part of the map, so definitely not in this part of the colony. I mean, we've already seen what happens when you have people sleeping near the front of the colony. So, how many bodies we got? 25. And Diggs is hauling one off to chop up. God, they're prioritizing. They're prioritizing it, you monsters. It's minus 17 degrees in there. I'll turn on the other cooler because it seems to be having a slight problem keeping up with staying cool. Oh, probably because the door keeps opening. People are rushing in and out constantly. Yeah, that's completely ruining the temperature in there. Oh! And just like that, we find metal. Thanks, game. Not like I needed any, but whatever, game. What's that? A leg. Where'd the leg come from? Did we grow that? Wait, if he's just... Oh, we've got another eye! McKinney! You can get another eye! So we've already installed the right eye. Let's install... the left eye. So I'm installing natural eye to the right and installing eye to the left. We'll see what the difference is. So we're going to be fixing up his cataracts. No more cataracts for you. Unfortunately, we can't do much for Spartak besides give him an eye. Actually, cancel that. We'll give Spartak actual sight, because even though he's got cataracts, he can actually see out of it, I think. Yeah, his sight's poor, 65. His sight's 50, so we're going to give him an eye. We're going to give Spartak an eye. We don't want to harvest his left eye, we just want to install a right eye. Meh. So yeah, good job. And, oh yeah, he brought the... Whoa, I'm on fast forward, I didn't even realize it. And you know what? We are 10 minutes in, we've not been attacked yet. That's a first. This is a first for RimWorld. We are always being attacked. Speaking of being attacked, ship, build the ship. The ship is a big deal. I also want to grow some cotton. Oh yeah, you're growing Devil Strand, aren't you? We'll grow some cotton. I'll make a little growing zone there. Outside. Just outside. Nothing special. Just growing some spare cotton. Cotton plant, there we go. Now the cotton, I'm thinking about using it for carpets. Just to make the place look a little more customized, change up the way that these little bunks look. They don't look very friendly and appealing, do they? I mean, they don't spend too long in there. I mean, they go there every night and sleep there and that's it. They're done. But you want to make them feel happy for living there. And it might increase how they feel about the room, because I think they complain it's a bit cramped. I don't know. Either way, Spartak's getting his brand new eye. So what else can we grow? Because what can we grow? Let's grow some things. Craft a liver, stomach, a kidney, a heart, lung, leg. Actually, we've got quite a few people with stumped legs, haven't we? Because the sniper rounds keep shooting them off. yes, and all the original colonists had their noses shot off. Because they don't need those. Thul could do with a new leg. Sarah's nose was bitten off. Diggs's nose was shot off. McKinney had his middle toe bitten off. Crazy. Let's check. Left arm, scratch scar. We could replace his right arm. If we can just start growing all these things, we can get rid of all the injuries that everyone's got. Yeah, we need quite a few legs. We need at least 4 legs, 5 legs. And a couple of eyes. So we'll make a couple of eyes and a couple of legs. An eye, leg. And we'll make a leg. We'll make about 6 legs. 2 eyes, 6 legs. I don't know how much meat these are going to take. Let's have a look. 60 human meat. That's like a body a leg. What? How can... That needs balancing a little. If a body brings out 75, how can 60 meat be required to make 1 leg? I don't know. Whatever, game. Maybe that actually balances it out, but... Uh-oh. These bodies are starting to go rot. Oh, I need to add a cooler to it, don't I? Deconstruct that. We'll add a cooler. I'm looking at it. We'll have a look to see how affected the batteries are during the night when there's no power being generated. I mean, the thing only takes 250 watts. This whole system generates like 3,000 or something like that. Not I don't know. Oh yeah, it doesn't go down much at all. 1 o'clock in the morning. There we go. Now it's at a cooler. And there's power being generated now, so it only goes down to about 977 before it generates more electricity again. That's out of 1,000. That's barely uses any power. So yeah, having a cooler on constantly will be beneficial for this place, I guess. But yeah, we need to keep these bodies refrigerated pretty quickly. Is anyone on the case? Anybody at all? Will, turn your backside around. Oh, Jerk's doing it. Where's Jerk? You're nowhere near. Will, you do it. What? Jerk. I'll kick your ass. Work on the cooler, go. Oh, he's got to move that. Work on the cooler, now. The metal's right next to you, you've got no excuses. Oh, we need to research more of the ship, so we'll do that. What's that? A group of hungry alpha beavers have arrived. Uh-oh. Try to eliminate them before they decimate every last tree in the region. How many are we talking here? 11. You know what to do, Thule. You know what to do, Thule. Will, what are you up to? You still doing the cooler? Good. Get it constructed. Much appreciated. Alright, let's bring it down to like minus 30. We want to keep it constantly cold, so even when it warms up, we want it to stay cold. I still don't get why the crematorium doesn't actually make any heat, because this doesn't make any sense. How can you have a really hot crematorium in a warm place? I mean, imagine if it had a door, that'd make more sense, but it doesn't have a door, so this should be generating so much heat. Is Thule hunting them? Oh yeah, Thule's going out to decimate these poor little alpha beavers. Thule with a minigun versus alpha beavers. Who will win? Who will lose? You decide. Well, actually, no, he decides. Alright, he's moving to the new location to where... God, they're really devouring all the trees. They're all gone. Thule. Oh, he got one shot in. Oh. Oh. The minigun is an absolutely terrible weapon to hunt with. It really is, but I like it just because it kills every other animal and damages everything in the area. Because, like, the more you destroy, the better. They see there's a whole group there, and he's firing into the middle of them. So he's damaging a bunch of alpha beavers. That makes more sense to me. There you go, he shot one of them. And he wasn't even hunting that one. Knocked out another. That's three dead, and he's not actually hunting those specific ones. That's why I like this. He's hunting that one there. Which is eating the oak tree that's right next to him. Oh, come on, Thule. He's point blank. Don't make me get the Uzi out. See, he's not even aiming at that one. He shot it. So, yeah, Thule's doing a great job in hunting down these alpha beavers. And the room is now minus 15 degrees Celsius. These bodies will stop rotting. I mean, the ones that have already rotted need cooking. Oh, that's why no one's cooking. Starvation, what's up? McClure? What are you doing, McClure? Oh. He'd rather make a leg than eat. He'd rather make a leg than eat. Crazy son of a bacon. Go eat! Finish it later, McClure. You're the only one we've got who's capable of doing this. Sarah! Why'd you take it out? Sarah, why would you do that? Why would you do that? Starving. He ain't starving anymore. He's very tired. Go to bed. He didn't eat! What? Right, that's it. I'm gonna have to suspend these. He's not eating. Are you kidding me? McClure, go eat. Now go to bed. You idiot. You fool. Oh, we've still got a prisoner? I thought they were all dead. I'm sorry, guys. I thought you were all dead. Difficulty 99, I may as well get rid of him. The only one worth possibly recruiting is M-Bai. I'm going to rename you when I get you. Let's call you M. Or something. We've got human meat being brought outside. These things are going to start rotting. So yeah, the battery's being drained at minus 500 watts. It should go down to about 950 before we start getting power again. Ish. If my math's correct, anyway. So 960... No, 960. That's even better than what I thought. Awesome. Phil, how's the hunting? He tied you out. Two colonists are idle. Not a lady. Yeah, you can keep calling them a lady. You're not a lady. Not a lady doesn't do anything because they've got no skills to do anything. I've set everybody to do everything. Even cooking, if possible. And we put Menino as a spare doctor because his doctoring skills isn't too terrible. better than everybody else's. 1% chance to recruit mink? I am ashamed. Thul, eat your meal. Right, let's unsuspend these because I think you'll be fine now. Right, we've got spare eyes, so McKinney, let's get you your left eye. Who's next? Did I make two eyes? Why did I make two eyes? Oh, someone else had cataracts, didn't they? But they kept it quiet. Yeah, Adam. Adam's got a cataract, hasn't he? Alright, we'll install natural eye for you as well. I don't know how many eyes we've got. The game says I have two. I need to make one more by the looks of it. Just waiting for these to get destroyed so I can replace them with sandbags. But it looks like no one wants to because no one's attacking us. We are at war with three factions, aren't we? Yeah, we're at war with three factions. These pirates, I don't get it. These guys never attack us. They only ever jump in. And they haven't done that for a while. Ever since I moved these outside, they've not attacked us. What's Spartak up to? Butchering. Yes, little corpse. Come with me. Yeah, so I'm not really going to cremate anybody until... Because... I don't see the point in cremating anymore. Turning the enemy bodies into... other usable parts we can use to repair our colonists with makes way more sense than anything else. So actually, I'm going to turn this thing off. No point in using it. We need the cooler, of course, to keep the bodies preserved, but I'm going to keep the crematorium off until we just don't need the human meat anymore. Oh, I didn't extend the thing that... Whoa! We got a wall! Actually, just deconstruct that one. I don't want anything getting in. I want to see what's in there. Need to extend that zone, don't we? Shazam. There we go. The zone's bigger now. You got no excuses. McClaw's destroying that wall. And there's nothing in it. Okay. Deconstruct that wall. We'll claim inside there as well. A new area has been revealed. And that's where the door was. Cute. I don't know if this room's going to be too big for cooling. I hope not. Me Nino's going nuts for whatever reason. Extremely hungry. Wait, Menino's got enough skill? I thought you needed to be... Oh... Why, game? Why? I thought you had to be a certain level to get... Or maybe you have to be a certain level to get... That one done? Medicine level 9. Oh, right. So I've been waiting all this time for no reason? I thought they were all level 9s. But apparently you need level 7 to do a leg. Fair enough. Let's make a couple more of these organ vats. They're kind of cute. Even though they're killing my colonists, they're kind of cute. You've detected the cluster of cargo pods. What have we got? Ah, it's pretty far. Not interested. Well, I say it's pretty far. It's not really. But people keep appearing here, and I don't want any of my colonists to die. Well, at least die from something dumb like that. And you know, get some food, you'll be fine. No, no, what are you doing? Is he starving himself? Medido, he's starving himself. He's starving himself. Go eat. That's really annoying. That doesn't make any sense. The only thing I can put that down to is that was coded really incorrectly. But I can't remember if this is a mod or not. So if it's a mod, then it's not the developer's fault. I can't remember. Is this a mod? Of course it's a mod. It makes too much sense. Of course it's a mod. Of course. I'm watching you, McClure. I will suspend this if you don't get any food or rest. Then we'll kick your ass. I'll get a couple of legs done. What are you doing, Will? Carrying human level to stockpile 7? Okay. Huh. For once, they figured going that way would be quicker. It's really slow to get out, but... What would you have me do, game? McClure, don't get hungry. I'll kill you. How's the research going, Diggs? It's not going at all. Thanks, Diggs. Much appreciated. We got some human meat set there that's going to spoil in 3 days if you don't pick it up. Oh, Diggs just got it. Antimatter reactor? Let's get that done. We get free power if we do that. Can't wait to buy the soundtrack for this game. It's just so good. We need another eye. Oh, wait, did Sarah level up? Wait, what? No, she's doing a leg. Never mind. I thought that was awesome, but it wasn't. Never mind. So yeah, we're doing pretty good. The cannon growing is going exceptionally well by the looks of it. We've got ourselves... Oh, what's that? Oh. Oh, sweet! They've dropped right in our base. I'll take them. We have 33 cloth from the cotton. Nice. Unfortunately, it costs like 5 per floor, isn't it? Yeah, 5 cloth per block, so... To do a 4x4, we need 16. That's a lot of cloth we're going to need. Sarah, I'm watching you. Oh, for the love of it. You better be almost done, Sarah. Oh, for the love of... This is getting beyond a joke. Suspend. And suspend. Ugh. Terrible. Yeah, I can't believe that's one thing I'm going to have to do. I'm going to have to babysit my colonists just to make sure they don't die. Alright, Sarah's eaten, and how's McKinney doing? McKinney's doing good as well, they've both eaten, so I'll then suspend them in the morning. Boop, there we go. Unsuspended. There you go, they won't go nuts on me now. Not been attacked in a while, game. And of course, they're starting again from fresh. Kind of annoying, but I'll live. Did I extend the zones? Yeah, I did. I mean, it's staying exceptionally cold. Starvation. Oh, for the love of... Oh, McClure, not McKinney. God damn it. This is what happens when you've got 2 McClures. McMix. Are you good now? Are you good? Kick your ass. Unsuspend. Come on, McClure, come finish it. No, don't feed anybody anything. Get your job done. He's doing? Oh, did someone take the... No? Nobody took the meat. Oh, yeah, they took the meat. But they did it! They did it! Yay! We got a leg done. Hurrah! Hooray! No more babysitting. Oh, this game. Still got some corpses to do. Those 4 are just going to have to rot there forever. I mean, they're not going to rot any more than what they are. And nobody's going nuts from picking them up every once in a while. I'm assuming the alpha beavers are dead. I didn't even bother to check. That's every tree destroyed in that area. I mean, they grow back, but that's every tree destroyed here. Another tree there. They didn't get this far. Huh. Cool. Group of travelers are passing by. They're not visiting, they're just passing by. I'm tempted to wall this part off. Or at least wall it off so they have to walk all the way around and come through our base to get there. Like maybe mine through here and then wall it off. Because we could really use that help. That help would really come in handy. What is this? Granite? There's a lot of granite here. 50, 60. That's quite a lot. We could build a wall with it. I need granite. I'm gonna wall this off. And then we're gonna mine. It's probably a terrible idea. It's probably an awful idea. But let's do it! Yeah, I'll just make a one by one tunnel through the mountain. That'd be the best way of going about it, I think. It's the only way I can think of, anyway. And then we'll wall this path when this wall's complete. Wait, hold on. There we go. Unlock the granite and suddenly everyone will start building it. Hey, now everybody's woken up. Yay. Get your job done. Huh, they put the alpha beaver in there. Fair enough. And not a ladies decided to start a little bit of mining. I think we've got enough granite. If not, we'll just build with slate. Pause. Damn it. Dag nabbit. Dag nabbit indeed. Okay, if I cancel being able to touch that, everyone should chill out. Right, what is your decision now, guys? Right, they're walking off. Alright. Oh, no, except for McClaw, but I think McClaw's just... Don't build anything. Don't. In fact, everybody get inside. Right, you're all getting locked in. It's the only thing I can think of. What's up with you? You hungry? You've eaten. Will, get inside. You guys have dropped a corpse? You guys are insane. Why would you drop a corpse? Right, doors are locked. Alright, a large piece of ancient ship has crashed nearby. Your colonists can feel it in the back of their mind, exhorting unspeakable acts. It must have an onboard AI persona with a psychic projection ability, and this AI is not friendly. Destroy it as soon as possible. We can do that. Let's do it. I think that's why Menino's going nuts, actually. Psychic drone, it's pushing him slightly over the edge. Alright, how's everybody feeling? Because... Oh crap, everyone's not happy about it. We need people who are in good enough spirits to fire this thing. Well, Sarah's in good enough spirits. Get on the plasteel one. McKinney, we'll take you. Trigger, we'll take you. Jerk. you can go on. Tail, you can go on. And last but not least... Oh, come on. It's got to be someone. Carrie, of course. Right. Manually aim everybody at the ship. Take that ship out. We do not need to buy anything from this salesman. We have everything we need, and we have to keep thinking that, and then maybe, just maybe, they'll go away. Alright. I'm hoping someone else is on warden duty. Nope, Sarah's our only warden. For now, I think Trigger and McKinney are all going towards the machines as well. Well, they're just going to have to deal with not having anything. In fact, who's our most useless colonist? It seems everybody's got a use right now. I think it's because we're using Carrie. God damn it, Carrie. Oh, Carrie's already firing. Oh, got mortars out already. Missed. Destroy it like you mean it. Trobo, you are now on warden duty. Actually, first someone in there. We'll see who's the most useless. I don't know who's the most useless, to be honest. Except for Carrie. Not a lady. Your name sticks out. Not a lady, you are now warden. Congratulations. Now go feed them. Oh, I think we hit him. Oh no, that was the psychic. Oh. Unless we hit it once. Oop, twice. If it gets damaged enough, they start attacking us. Men will break soon. Menino, get over it, buddy. If you don't get over it, we'll just shoot you. So, the enemy have 4 scythers and 3 centipedes, all with inferno cannons. That's always fun. Just firing indiscriminately in that area. Mostly trying to target the crashed ship, but never really hitting. Takes so long, but... Oh, we killed a pig! Oh, we killed 2 pigs. The fire's slowly spreading, but I think it'll go out eventually. Oh, 3 pigs. Well, in theory, the animals would flee from the exploding area in general fear. So I'd imagine they'd get a little better AI one day. So they run away from fires or run away from explosions and stuff. And gunshots, making hunting a little bit harder. Snow? What? Where'd the snow come from? Oh, I'm assuming the snow's meant to be ash. It's the only thing I'm thinking of. There should be no snow there. Well, for some reason there's snow. Yeah, I'm thinking it's meant to be ash. Now, I'll keep firing. Oh. Yeah, I need to think about their health, don't I? Yeah, they're getting pretty low. Right, you guys have done great work. Go do your thing. Diggs, you are now up. I know you're doing research, but you can get back to that later. Jari, you're up. Spartak, you're up. Trobo. Not a lady. And of course, Mr. White. Because we need Walter White to do this, don't we? We need him to cook up some mortar rounds and shoot them. Oh, we've taken out Scyther. Nice. 1 down, 1 to go. Well, 4 to go. 3 more to go, actually. Oh, we killed the turtle. Oh, the rain's taking care of the fire. Keep firing, and all will be well. Especially they don't go a little bit nuts because they can't actually get out of the colony. But then again, they're safe in the colony, so they shouldn't really complain. The Devil Strand's growing. It's going to take 33 days to grow. Really? Look at all that human meat we've got. 588 human meat.
What?
Stop eating people. I think that's the message the game's trying to give me. Oh boy. Don't see any more red X's anywhere. Except for the scythe and a couple of pigs. Oh, it seems we destroyed the other pig. And that poor little pig is gonna die because he's in shock. He's shocked. He lost one of his legs. McClaw's birthday? Happy birthday, McClaw. Stop being never stop being awesome. Oh, we hit it again. As soon as it goes to 500, these guys actually start charging your base. But we've got 5 snipers sitting and waiting, and those inferno cannons aren't going to do much except for... Oh, set on fire. Metal breaks soon. What do we got? Oh, it's Menino. Ignore it. Carry on. Oh. Oh, oh, oh. 700. Come on. Hit it, damn it. Come on, it's been nearly 3 days since the crash ship woke up. A trade ship's passing by. They're a bulk trader. Menino, let's keep you busy. So we can sell them some squirrel skin. We don't care about the squirrel skin. Synthroid skin. Beaver skin, we don't care about. They can take that. The human leather. I don't want to make anything out of human leather. Sell it. Just sell it. We don't want it. We don't want that. Synthread we'll keep for now. Marble blocks. Why does he want marble? Oh, because we sell. Because, yeah, I see. Don't really want to buy any blocks. I mean, we've got some hyperweave we could buy, but the cost per? That's not very good at all. Berries. Yeah. It's not really got anything I really want to buy. He's got a bit of steel. I think I'll take the steel. So yeah, we'll give him some money for the steel. Also we'll buy some plasteel, I guess. No, we won't. We've got enough plasteel. We don't need any more. And we'll take some cloth as well. All the snow in the area. I don't get it. It just seems to just generate a big circle of snow. It must be ash. It's the only thing I can put it under. Come on, guys. It's almost been three days. It's the psychic drone level increases the longer it's there. Oh, one more time. I'm thinking they're gonna attack. Metal break soon. Jari, right? I forgot about you guys. How's your health? Yep, go on. You've done well, guys. We'll get other people on. Thule, wake up. You're up. Sarah, you're coming back. McKinney, you may be a little bit hungry, but you'll be fine. Trigger, you're up too. Will, you're up. Vince, you're up. Oop. Right, that's all of them. Right. Continue firing. Do not let up. Thule, you'll be going outside and kicking their ass anyway. Probably send Sarah with you. Just have to hit it like one more time. One more time. One more time. Ooh, right in the middle of those sandbags. Missed again. What do we got? Cargo pods crashing nearby. Perhaps you'll find something useful in the wreckage. What do we got? Cloth. We'll take that.